Well, today I'm gonna tell you a little bit about my painting that I called Muse. I've created this painting in my teacher training in how to teach other people to paint with Shaila Sophia. And this particular painting was, it happened in Sonoma. And the reason that the grapes came through, I think is very much, has very much to do with Sonoma being a wine country. I don't really drink much wine, not at all. And I don't eat much grape. But it was interesting how it showed up in my painting. And I think that I've connected to earth and the energy, the sunshine of this beautiful place. And that's where it came through. But the deeper meaning of this particular painting is connection to universal flow of grace. And in I Ching, it's hexagram 22. And that hexagram is about being graceful in your life and finding the way to move through life, no matter what obstacles, no matter what challenges, in a way that is connected to grace as a divine flow. And thinking of grace, I always think about how we have a particular life purpose and we have a particular challenge in our life and we have a particular life work. And no matter what you think about it, it'll bring you there. So very long ago, I did a MAP assessment, M-A-P-P. It's a trait assessment, what kind of work you can do. And I was already a teacher. I was studying to dance, a dance, but on that assessment, I came up as a recreational teacher, and I could not understand that because I was always a very formal teacher, and I have 2 degrees in education. And all of a sudden, it tells me you will be teaching drawing and dancing, and you're going to be doing things that totally are not traditional. I was very surprised. But what's interesting that today I actually do this. I teach dance, I teach Zumba and Tango, and I also paint, and I teach other people how to express themselves creatively. And my major work is becoming aware of what this person's trait and power is, and then reflect it back so they can find their own life purpose, and they can own their own power and see how they can express it in the world. Some people do like to express this, as artists, and I definitely help those as well. But most of the people are not necessarily becoming artists, but they put intentional creativity into their life. So how this painting is being created is very much about creation, intentional creativity method. So it starts with a lot of intention on the canvas. I put in what I need for my next step, for my muse to awaken and to bring in the wonderful creations that are happening through me being a channel of divine grace. And then I put in all the colors that my heart desires in that moment. And you can see a dark blue is a royal color, it's the color of royal manifestation, and red is the fire. And fire for me symbolizes something new, something that comes into your life. It burns sometimes what was there before, but then it clears up the space for something new. And then you see the swan in here, and the swan is the image of grace. Very often you might see the swans in that shape, and they're kissing each other, creating a heart. And so it's about loving yourself, your presence in the world, loving the world, being in awe of what is being created by that divine grace, and also you being a channel of that and absorbing what you are able to create. And the partner of swan is a deer, so you'll see some of the antlers up there. What was interesting, as I was driving through Sonoma country, I've seen a lot of grapevines that were cut down for the winter, and they actually did look like antlers of the deer. And this is where it came from, and then I realized what was happening and how it's all connected. And then there is a part of the painting, you're not actually seeing it very well at the very bottom, that has a compass to right, moving to the north, through north, understanding your direction in life, And the very bottom is the skeleton that represents piranha, that is part of this trinity. And piranha is about stripping everything down to the bone, getting down to the very basic before you can create. So you can see the red thread connecting us, and I actually am doing my first red thread creative circle this Wednesday. I've done a lot of circles, but right now I'm working with the idea that we're all created in the red thread, the bloodline of creative beings. At, as a woman, you bring the creation into life. This is how you create the child. This is how you create your projects. And red thread is something that connects us, and those people who understand what red thread is about, they're actually drawn to each other. And so we are connected in the red thread in our creative projects. And then the grapes. So the grapes, like I said, were not necessarily my first object to draw, and I did not expect that in my painting. So when they showed up, I went and I researched what the grapes are all about. And what I've discovered is that grapes have so many healing properties that they actually preserve. There is a substance that is derived from them that's called preservatrol, and they actually preserve your usefulness. They help you to preserve the memory. They help you to be full of juice of life, and their color is crimson and gold and purple. Talk to your heart, and the sweetness of the grape, and there is this sour-sweet sensation on your tongue and tangy feeling. There is so much that you can really get from tasting it and knowing that when you bring it into your body, it works with your body in a way that makes you more alive and passionate about your life, and actually lots of healing properties. And you probably see the ears here. So these are the ears of the deer. And again, first time I traveled to Petaluma was long ago for the business sequence with Richard Rudd. It was my first encounter. I've known him for many years, but that was my first encounter with him as a person, and we became friends and worked together for many years. And in Petaluma, I've seen the deers that I haven't seen before with the ears that are really huge. And I had an amazing experience of listening to myself, to the nature. There was my first clairvoyant experience in ION, Noetic Science Institute, where I've gotten an amazing download of my future life that all unfolded in divine timing. So this painting for me represents the return to Petaluma 10 years later, at that other level of my creative being. And so she looks into the world with the eyes of wonder and the eyes of observation and the eyes of contemplation. And she's looking for divine grace, to bring that divine grace into physical manifestation. So it's a template of consciousness. And people who meditate with those images, these are positive feminine images that help you understand yourself. Whether you're a woman or a man, understand your feminine flow as a divine grace, as something that is needed in this particular time on earth, something that is helping preserve the dignity of humanity, and it helps with feeling good. And so this image has a lot, there is a light language here as well. It has a lot of information in it. And I'm giving you this download so you know how to use it when you look at that image and what it can do for you when you allow yourself to be present to her presence. So it's divine grace in action through me. It showed up in the world. I'm really grateful for being able to channel those images and have a process, interactive process, in which she talks to me. And so at the end, she said, my name is the medicine woman. And I never actually thought of myself as a medicine woman. And of course, people who know me, I do a lot of healing. I'm an energy intuitive. I can see things in the body. I see things in the mind. I do readings for people. I really am a medicine woman, but I never thought about myself as that. Life coach and educator is the words I normally use. And so when she said, I am the, you are, and we are the medicine woman, and our medicine is the fiery mind, and we are cooking, we are brewing something that gives people life, the life force energy, the energy to create, the passion to create, the passion to look at the world with the bright eyes and find something to inspire yourself and others with your work. I actually accepted that and said, thank you very much. I am the medicine woman, and my medicine is, it's filled with passion and love for humanity and divine grace and boldness and fiery mind. And we've been burned at stake for many, many, many millennia, but right now it's your time. Your time to create, your time to open your eyes, your time to be. And with that, I give it to you.